Hey guys, recently I talked about the types of the fields of social work that I'm not really interested in or that I wouldn't be the right fit for. I really talked about kind of five of them and five of the fields I kind of crossed out for myself, that being focusing primarily on the severely mentally ill. Not that I've said before that I love working with these populations, but it's not a population that I want to just focus on for my entire career. School social work, social work in hospitals, so I don't really want to do hospital social work, and I don't want to work in ACS, you know, Administration for Children's Services, or in the foster care system, especially with the government. I don't want to work in end-of-life care or bereavement. So these are the kind of five fields of social work I kind of knocked out for myself, and that's just me. You know, many other people, many other social workers out there, that's their field. And I appreciate them for that. I respect them for that. But I feel like that those are kind of my areas that I don't really want to spend my entire life doing. That's not my kind of social work. Which begs the question, well then, what is the kinds of social work that would be for me? And this is the kind of question, you know, that I've been wrecking around, thinking about a lot. But I think I finally have pretty much a general answer to this. And this really is important to have now because I met with my faculty advisor, my practice professor, in order to discuss my next year placement. And my second year placement is extremely important because that becomes pretty much my expertise. So where will I be placed second year and be more focused in that second year? And I have an answer now. The answer seems pretty broad. I think it's an extremely broad one. But I think the analogy that I can draw from is kind of with surgery. As a surgeon, there are many different kinds of specialty surgery you get into. There's neurosurgery, there's I forgot how you say that word, but the one that you deal with bones, right? And there's plastic surgery, there is the heart one. The urinary tract one, there's many different kinds of fields of surgery. Like that, there's many different fields of social work. And even with surgery, there's something called general surgery, right? And that's mainly dealing with like just this general area right here and just pretty much overall generalist surgery. And I feel like that's the type of social work I guess would be akin to that I would be very interested in doing, just kind of a general social work. Because there are different areas that are listed, fields of social work, and some of them are extremely specific, like hospital social work, very specific, or medical social work, you know, social work that is for mentally ill, very specific, again, and school social work and law. Actually, I am interested in that, but as a pretty much very specific focus, there was one field that says adults with contemporary issues. Like what? Wait, that's the entire field, adults with contemporary issues? And that's pretty much adults with, and there are these issues that get listed. And there's not a single issue on there that I'm just like, oh no, I don't want to do that. I want to do all of them. Adults with homelessness issues, poverty, trauma, discrimination, and domestic violence. The lack of social and emotional support, mental illness, chemical addiction, I think those are pretty much the main eight ones. Adults with those issues, and I was just like, shoot, yeah, I would be totally on board with that. And then that's, I think, my general expertise. I really want to focus on that, and it's really the area I'm most experienced with. Oddly enough, I've interned at Housing Works, and I've worked at a homeless shelter. I've interned with Chelsea Housing Group of Hudson Guilds, so it was kind of related with the settlement house. And I really would like to work in a residential setting, like settlement houses, shelters. I would like to work in a prison or with kind of law firm, like Legal Aid Society. Those would be really great to work with, and I'm particularly really good working with adults. So I think that's kind of my area of expertise. And I really went into social work. I'm thinking now to kind of think of my mantra, you know, my little philosophy in life and little tidbit, you know, what can we say in like a short, brief sentence about it? And I really have to say, I do this kind of work because I think that status quo is not acceptable. And status quo can be changed. So it's really, I want to change this reality that is so horrible for many people. Many people dealing with issues of homelessness, of poverty, of the stress disorder, and anxiety issues, and addictions, and poverty, and all those kind of things. That's what I really want to kind of dig at. And right now, I am an intern in a high school. I think the work that I do is extremely important, but I just feel like the work that I do currently doesn't really get to those issues. And so that's what I really want to kind of focus on as my like lifelong career. And then there was a section for the elderly, and I feel like I would like to work with the elderly too. The only areas I don't really want to work in elderly with is bereavement or end-of-life care. I just don't think I can handle that. But the other things I can handle really well, I think I would love to work in nursing homes. Like I said, kind of residential settings where things are more of that kind of vibe. I don't want to work in a hospital because it's a very different vibe. And I've been in nursing homes and I've been in hospitals before, mainly because my mom has been a nurse in both of those kind of settings. And I've been to my mom's workplaces many times. So that's the kind of thing I want to do. And then I guess, you know, some other kind of minor specialties I might get involved with later would be, you know, working with children and families. Though I don't think that's likely because I lack experience for that. I lack the expertise for that. So, but it's one area that I could possibly get into, you know. And the area of social work and law, I think is extremely important. And my second year placement, if I'm selected for this extra kind of field learning opportunity, they have this thing called micro-macro practice. So it's learning about policy. And so if I can kind of also gain a more specialty or more expertise in policy making, I think that would be very powerful in the kind of social worker that I become and in various nonprofit work. And I'm also thinking, you know, maybe it's because I'm an NYU student and NYU is very clinically focused. It's known for that. I think they're trying to branch off from that label that is a very clinically focused school at this point. And they're trying to include more social justice oriented work into their curriculum and whatever. But it's still a very clinically oriented school. And my supervisor in my high school was just like, well, it's interesting, David, that, you know, you have such like macro perspective on things and you like to think about policy and social justice. Like, how did you end up in NYU? Why are you going to NYU when NYU is known for such deep clinical focus? And, you know, I'm starting to find out why. You know, I think I've been able to give an answer to that question, but now I have a very clearer answer to this. And that's really because I enjoy interacting directly with clients. And to me, the best joy I feel is direct practice with clients. So I think NYU makes sense. If I went to Columbia or even Hunter's, the policy track is extremely powerful and awesome. But I don't think it would have been my suit. I still really like doing clinical direct practice work, but with thinking about social justice and policy in mind, I think that's really what I would like to do. In the future, maybe if I'm, you know, when I get to 50 years old or 40 years old, I actually, the idea of opening my private practice doesn't sound too bad, actually. I think that would be pretty cool. And I'm starting to learn a lot about, like, different pay scales I could charge as a private practice. So I can actually even, you know, I could even have clients who are in poverty, but still, you know, provide private practice therapy to them. And that would be pretty cool, you know, have kind of a pay scale for them. And I have to learn more about, like, accepting insurance, like Medicaid and Medicare. And I would like to be able to be a private therapist that does that. But even if it's not, I don't know, looking way in the future now, this is unrealistic to think this far ahead. But the idea of being, like, a private practice doesn't doesn't turn me off. Like, I think that's a, you know, a doable idea for me, even in, like, corporate settings. For some reason, like, I've always had this, like, long ago, I've always had that, like, icky feeling about corporate social work. But now that I think about it, it's doesn't really, I no longer have that icky feeling about it. I think it could still be quite interesting and quite enjoyable, too, and important, too. I in some ways, I think corporate social work is important, too. And by corporate social work, I mean, like, you know, therapist or counseling people in corporations. So, for example, a social worker that provides therapy services to an employee at Google or something. That is an example of a corporate social worker. And, like, for some reason, I think that would be pretty cool, too. I mean, the good amount of money I would get as a corporate social worker doesn't hurt. But just because I've always been kind of this field, I've been drawn into it because it's the field about kind of working towards or working for and with populations that are the most oppressed, the most vulnerable, and have been historically the most voiceless. So advocating for them and assisting them and coming to understand them and supporting them, that really is the goal that I want to kind of strive towards in my profession. This aim towards social justice, I aim towards ameliorating homelessness, attacking poverty, tackling issues of institutional racism and discrimination. And that really always has been my main purpose. I think that's the kind of social worker that I want to be, a social worker that really tackles that as directly as possible. You know, and it's gonna be tough. I'm not sure how much of success I will have in doing that, but that's ultimately my goal in the type of social worker that I want to be. So it's gonna be. I am very curious what kind of placement internship that I will get for my second year placement. I'm pretty excited now. I'll learn what kind of placement I get by this August, I think, at the latest, you know, June at the earliest. So it would be very interesting to see what kind I get. Right now, I just have to finish my school internship. You know, I'm still at the high school. I provide counseling to ninth grade students, and I do group work with ninth grade students. So I'm still in the realm of school social work, which I do very much enjoy. So I think it's a very important type of work. I'm just saying that it's not the type of work I see myself doing for the rest of my life. You know, and that's, I think there are other types of social work that are more akin to that. And that really is in this field of adults with contemporary issues, such a broad field, I think, and one that encompasses many different agencies and settings. And I can also kind of pick out what kind of settings in this field, in this broad field, I don't want to work in. For example, I don't want to work in a setting that is abstinence-based and not harm reduction approach. And this is kind of a jargon. Many people who are not in our field might not really understand what the hell am I saying by saying harm reduction-based, whatever. And I don't really get into that too much detail, but that I'm just saying that I am a huge proponent of harm reduction. And a setting that doesn't have that kind of emphasis, I would not want to work in it, period. You know, some government settings I would not want to work in. You know, some government agencies. The one agency I wouldn't mind working in is, like, Veterans Administration. I would actually would like working in the VA hospitals or something like that. Not necessarily hospitals, but, you know, VA institutions would be cool. You know, but working in, like, state prisons or for-profit prisons, not really sure I want to do that, especially not if it's like as a probation officer or anything like that, or warden or something like that. It really, I'd rather probably prefer to be tied in with like a nonprofit agency, a private nonprofit that provides that kind of services to prison population or recently released from prison population, so reentry kind of service. Anyway, that's kind of my whole blabbering about the kind of social work I'm pretty much passionate about, and we'll see what happens with me. I still have one more year of social work education to do to get my MSW, and then after that is also, it's still a long road ahead of me in this career. But yeah, I don't know what's gonna happen, but that's just me kind of just throwing out my thoughts in kind of where I'm at with my career right now, if you could call it that, career.